Now, the name of the current Garissa governor, Bwana Ali Korane, has come up in the investigation of an attempted murder in the leafy suburb of Nairobi, Kileleshwa, where something happened that comes straight out of an action movie, or a violent movie if you like. And this is what has happened that has been linked to the governor. Yeah, a former employee of the Garissa executive, Bwana Idris Mukhtar, yeah, was in charge of finances, yeah, in the former Garissa government under the former governor, was shot 3 times in the head by a lone gunman, and he survived. Now, of course, he's still in very serious condition, but doctors are very positive. Yeah, in fact, the latest is that they've stabilized him. Now, the latest news which has just come in, yeah, concerning this very ugly affair, is that the chief suspect, yeah, the man who police believe was the lone gunman, yeah, is said to have just committed suicide in his police cell. What? Now, how does that even happen? Yeah, how does somebody commit suicide in a police cell? Anyway, hold on to that thought, we'll come back to it. Yeah, the deceased's name was David Moy. Now, unlike other attempted murder or murder investigations, the police had it a bit easy on this one. Yeah, thanks to CCTV footage, which showed the lone gunman, who was wearing a brown jacket, a pair of jeans, and a white cap, walk through the gate, yeah, and approach the car where Mr. Mukhtar was seated. And the CCTV shows very clearly him firing 3 times, yeah. And then he casually walked away, and there was a waiting motorcycle. He jumped onto it and escaped. Now, before this attempt on the life of Idris Mukhtar, there was a silver-colored car that had been trailing him and following him around for quite a number of days. Now, police have even found that. They found it in a garage in Gara, where it was being repainted. Yeah, it was silver, but now it was being given a coat of paint that was red. Now, Bwana Ali Korane's name first came to be mentioned in connection to this case when he was arrested on Tuesday this week, yeah, or rather picked up by police. He was not actually arrested. He was picked up by police for questioning, and then he was released. Governor Korane said in his Twitter page that actually he had been called in for questioning and not arrested, as the media announced. Now, Bwana Korane belongs to the Jubilee Party. Actually, he joined TNA in 2013, yeah, but he only got elected during the recent elections in August 2017 on the Jubilee ticket. And perhaps the most prominent news item connected to him was his recent benchmarking tour to the United States. Now, you can see photographs on your screens, yeah, connected to that tour, where he was obviously taking notes on how to control flooding, which is a major problem in Garissa County. Now, Idris Mukhtar, the man who was shot 3 times in the head, is described by people, most people, as a very good financial person, very intelligent young man. Yeah, he's about 33 years old. But he has also been mixed in some controversy. Yeah, he was fired by the previous Garissa government, under the previous governor. And after he was fired, he and two other people, his father, Dr. Aden Mukhtar, and Bwana Salah Yakub Farah, sued. Yeah, they sued the Garissa County government. And the court awarded them $17 million each. But the really interesting thing in this bizarre case is the fact that 2 days before Mr. Mukhtar, the younger Mr. Mukhtar, Idris Mukhtar, was shot 3 times, yeah, in an attempt to end his life, 2 days after that, he was due to file a case in court. Now, in this case, there were 10 other petitioners, yeah, but he was the main petitioner. And what was the case about? They were going to challenge the academic qualifications of the current governor, Bwana Korane. Wah, wah. Now, that is interesting, isn't it? But there's more, yeah? Mukhtar's dad, Aden Mukhtar, and another person called Salah Yakub Farah, yeah, you know, the people who were given the big award by the court, $17 million each, yeah? have given a statement to the police, and indeed they have told the press, that they believe the attempt on the life of Idris Mukhtar was related or connected to this petition they're going to file challenging the academic qualifications of the governor of Garissa. And now, a key suspect, the person believed to have been the lone gunman, and the person police was saying they were relying on to unravel this case, to get to the bottom of this case, has committed suicide in his police cell. Now, how do you commit suicide in a police cell? Because normally, in Kenya, people are not locked up alone in police cells. There are normally a lot of people in a police cell. And so there's a very huge question mark there. There's another mystery connected to this case. At the moment, there are several suspects, or there are several people who police are interrogating in connection to this attempted murder, who are in police custody. Yeah, they include the bodyguard of Bwana Ali Korane, a soldier who is said to be a security advisor to the county of Garissa, the owner of the car, which was being changed colors from silver to red, the Boda Boda rider, and a woman. However, the governor was interviewed by the police, and then he was not held. Now, that sounds a bit strange, doesn't it? Now, Governor Ali Korane was briefly in the army, but then left, and most of his career, many Kenyans will remember him as a DC, he was actually a DC in the late 80s, under the Moi government, Daniel Arap Moi government. We also know, this information is in the public domain, that Governor Korane said or indicated that he had a degree from the University of Nairobi, and of course the University of Nairobi disowned him, and this qualification he claimed he had, well, according to the Nairobi University. Now, we all know legally you cannot be a governor in Kenya unless you have minimum qualifications of a university degree. And this is why this petition, which was supposed to come up 2 days after Bwana Idris Mukhtar was shot, was going to be very interesting. It is not clear whether the other 10 petitioners will go ahead with it. But right now, of course, our prayers, Bwana Idris Mukhtar recovers completely. It is a miracle that we have to be grateful to Almighty God for, that a person who gets shot 3 times in the head is actually still in the land of the living. And doctors are even talking about his recovery. Now, sometimes news breaks when there are a lot of other very sensational things happening, and therefore it gets drowned. You know, people don't notice. People are not aware of it. So I thought it would be a good idea to bring members of this channel up to speed about this very strange, bizarre incident. And naturally, you know me, I'll be following this case very closely, on your behalf, until we get to the bottom of it. Because naturally, this is not the Kenya we want, where people are eliminated for whatever reason. And indeed, we have to appreciate the fact that ordinarily, this would just been would have ended up as just another unsolved attempted murder. But in my view, 2 things went wrong. The person survived. And then also that CCTV camera, which of course the person who shot Bwana Idris was not aware was that camera was there. Those 2 things went very wrong. And now it seems that this is the kind of case that will attract a lot of attention from Kenya. I shall do a few more follow-up videos as soon as I've finished my background checks, my small investigation here and there, to keep you up to speed with what's happening. Until next time, this is Chris Kumekucha.